Food processing facility sanitation is an integral part of good manufacturing practices. Effective sanitation aids in ensuring the wholesomeness, safety, and quality of shell eggs. The negative impacts on food safety and egg quality are a result of microbial growth. Research has shown that ineffective cleaning and sanitation practices or programs can lead to reduced quality duration or potential product contamination. Residual microorganisms can lead to egg spoilage or foodborne illness. Most of this training series will focus on the United States Department of Agriculture Agricultural Marketing Service pre-operational sanitation inspection expectations. However, remember that the Food and Drug Administration has oversight of consumer shell eggs in the United States, as stated in 21 CFR 117. Additionally, customers, accrediting organizations, such as Safe Quality Food, British Retail Consortium Global Standard, and others, as well as state and local regulatory agencies, may have additional facility sanitation expectations that can impact your facility. AMS sanitation requirements are meant to protect the integrity of the USDA grade mark by requiring additional sanitation expectations at facilities that utilize AMS voluntary grading services. To meet these goals, AMS inspectors will assess for voluntary grading program requirements during the pre-operational sanitation inspection and throughout processing operations by utilizing organoleptic inspection assessments. While AMS may review microbial test results as part of certain export programs, AMS does not conduct nor require swabbing or biological testing during routine sanitation assessments. So what is organoleptic inspection? Organoleptic inspection assessments include sight, smell, and touch. However, microbial growth will not always be seen, smelled, or felt. Critical areas are defined as equipment with potential surface contact with eggs or come in contact with wash water or air blown to dry the eggs. Non-critical areas are defined as areas that are not likely to imminently affect product quality. Non-critical does not mean it is not important. Non-critical unsatisfactory conditions should be addressed after the processing line has been started, unless unable to safely do so during processing.
In this module, the critical and non-critical areas of packer systems present on the processing line will be identified and discussed. Packer systems not only place eggs into cartons or flats, but package, stamp, and transport cartons to case packing area. Due to the complexity of packer systems, sanitation expectations will be covered in two modules. Additionally, examples will be used to illustrate the satisfactory and unsatisfactory condition of various components associated with packer systems. Egg processing facilities shall be thoroughly cleaned at the end of each operating day. The term reasonably clean is applied during the egg processing shift to indicate that equipment and processing areas are maintained with minimum egg meat accumulation. More explanation of these terms is presented in the introduction module. During this module, specific manufacturers will be mentioned merely to highlight packing systems unique to processing lines and how these systems are addressed during pre-operational sanitation inspections. In order for equipment cleanliness to be properly assessed, USDA AMS graders should be aware of the access and viewpoints for egg packer systems. The various models of egg graders have different access locations on the machine for viewing egg packer systems. All portions of egg packer systems must be available and accessible for assessment during pre-operational sanitation inspection. The packer system must be cleaned each day prior to processing. The egg packer systems are composed of multiple components and parts that make cleaning and assessment difficult. This complexity requires the division of the egg packer systems into sections that will be explored over two modules. One module will cover the lower portion, while this module covers the upper portion. Of the three different graders, MOBA packers are different from the Sanovo and Diamond. For simplicity, the MOBA packers will be discussed first, and then the Sanovo and Diamond packers will be discussed. On MOBA systems, after the egg leaves the gripper from the carriage system, it makes three vertical transitions through the trestle. The trestle accommodates three sets: the receiver set, buffer set, and drop set. Each set performs a specific function for egg transition. The receiver set consists of six polymer trays that are a removable cassette. The buffer set consists of six unlockable trays per set that are rotatable. The drop set consists of six polymer trays that deliver the eggs into the carton. The critical components are the polymer trays that contact the egg, the metal framing and bracing of the cassette drawer, and the trolley system used to pull the cassettes out are non-critical. For proper assessment, the receiver, buffer, and drop sets should be pulled out and observed for cleanliness. The buffer set should be rotated to view all polymer trays. A plant employee should present the sets, which includes rotation, for pre-operational sanitation inspection. Diamond and Sanova packers have brushes which assist eggs in making vertical transitions onto the packer lanes. While both graders have large round brushes, Sanova packers have an additional flat brush between the carriage system and the round brush. Except for the long mounting rod of the older style brushes, all brush assemblies are critical. After the egg passes through the brushes, wire transfer assemblies and trampolines with transfer pads cushion eggs as they transition onto the reservoir belt. Both the wire transfer assembly and trampolines with transfer pads are considered critical. The facility must have brushes removed to assess these components. The reservoir belt transition eggs from the trampoline towards egg packaging. Lane divider spacers are present to assist with egg alignment for packaging. Additional components that prevent eggs from piling up before packaging are present. These egg hold downs may be made from metal or polymer material and contact each egg before it is packed. The egg hold downs, support structures, lane dividers, and belts are all critical components. Non-critical areas of the reservoir belt section are limited to the outside framing and supports. On Diamond and Sanovo packers, the area of the packer that orients and drops eggs into the packaging is the packer head assembly. As Diamond packers transition from the reservoir assembly into the packer head assembly, eggs pass through additional egg guides prior to detection by the sensor bar. Once the sensor bar detects an egg in each position, the upper paddle assembly will assist the eggs across the spool assembly and lower paddle wheel assembly before dropping into the upper clamshells. Once in the upper clamshells, a second set of lower clamshells will receive the eggs and prepare to place them in the packaging. Apart from the sensor bar, all components mentioned are egg contact components and are critical. Non-critical components of the packer head will include framing, bracing, plastic shields, and guards. As Sanovo packers transition from the reservoir assembly into the packer head assembly, eggs pass through additional egg guides or divider assembly and hold down assembly before settling on the star wheels. Once the sensor bar, located in the hold-down assembly, detects an egg in each position, the star wheel will advance the eggs to the roller. As the eggs move forward, they move through the flapper assembly and are oriented by the paddle wheel as they fall into the upper clamshell assembly. From here, eggs are released into the lower moving clamshell assembly, which then places them into the packaging. Apart from the sensor bar, all components mentioned are egg contact components and are critical. Non-critical components of the packer head will include framing, bracing, plastic shields, and guards. Here we see the buffer set being assessed. Notice how a facility employee assists in opening the set and rotating the assembly for assessment. This critical buffer set appears to be satisfactorily clean. Then we see the additional assessment of the receiving set, again with the assistance of a facility employee. While this camera view does not allow for visualization of the critical cups, the non-critical bracing and drawer structure appear to be satisfactorily clean. This view of a buffer set shows residual egg meat on multiple areas of the set. This is an unsatisfactory critical finding. Here, we see that the buffer set appears to be satisfactorily clean. However, the drop set has egg meat on the far right tray. This is an unsatisfactory critical finding which should be addressed before processing begins. Taking a close look at the brushes of this packer lane, we find that the large round brush appears to be satisfactorily clean. However, the upper flat brush, as well as the clear plastic guard between brushes, has egg meat remaining. This is an unsatisfactory critical finding. In this view of the round brush, we see that eggshell remains on the brush. This would be an unsatisfactory critical finding. The eggshell should be removed before processing begins. Additionally, the conduit above the brush is beginning to accumulate dirt and grime. This is approaching an unsatisfactory, non-critical finding. Plant management should be notified for correction before it becomes too severe. Here is another view of an unsatisfactory critical deficiency. The round brush seen here has material and debris which has not been removed. The brush in this shot, while older, has been maintained in an acceptably clean condition. This is a satisfactory finding on a critical brush. On closer inspection, we see a few residual specks of debris. This very limited amount of material should not be cause for an unsatisfactory finding. Brush discoloration is not cause for an unsatisfactory finding. The flat brushes in this shot show discoloration, but are still clean and free of foreign material. The round brush also appears to be satisfactorily clean. This would be a critical, satisfactory finding. Here we see diamond packers. On the left, the front brush has been removed for proper cleaning of the trampoline surfaces. The trampolines and brush guards appear clean and satisfactory in a critical area. On the right, we see a trampoline and assembly that did not have the front brush removed for proper cleaning. Egg meat and eggshell remain on the trampolines and the egg deflectors. This is an unsatisfactory critical finding. In addition to the front brush, the rear brush should be removed to properly clean the wire transfer assembly and clean and assess the upper flat brush when present. Both the brushes and wire transfer assembly are satisfactory for these critical areas. The mylar covering of the trampoline can become brittle and crack over time, which allows the foam pad underneath to develop microbial growth. This is an unsatisfactory critical condition. Cracked mylar should be replaced before microbial growth occurs. If additional time is needed to correct unsatisfactory conditions, plant management should contact local USDA AMS supervision. Here we see the trampoline and mylar reservoir belt area. While the mylar covering of the trampoline and belt are in good condition and not cracked or broken, there is debris remaining on the surface. This would be an unsatisfactory critical finding and must be corrected before processing begins. Here is a view of the same reservoir assembly area that has been satisfactorily cleaned. Here we see the transition from the reservoir assembly into the packer assembly. While it looks like some cleaning has been conducted on this assembly, egg meat was not effectively removed from the rollers. This is an unsatisfactory critical finding. On closer inspection, we find that the mylar covers, called sleeve rollers, associated with rollers are missing from the second lane of the roller shaft assembly. This mylar retards the formation of microbial biofilms and eggstone on the rollers. While AMS does not require the presence of these mylar covers to be satisfactory, it is encouraged to maintain machinery as designed by the manufacturer. In addition, the presence of eggstone is an unsatisfactory critical finding. Looking from the other side of the packer head, we see that the upper and lower clamshell assemblies have been thoroughly cleaned, as well as the flapper. Additionally, the non-critical stainless steel structures and supports are satisfactorily clean. However, there is egg meat remaining on the paddle wheel assembly. This is a critical, unsatisfactory finding. This is an example of a satisfactorily cleaned, critical packer head assembly. We see that both sets of clamshells, paddle wheel, and sensor bar, as well as non-critical structural support and plastic guards, are thoroughly cleaned. There are many styles and configurations for egg packer systems. It is important to familiarize yourself with each egg processing system you encounter to ensure the packer system is effectively evaluated before processing begins each day. Keep in mind that in any system, egg contact areas and associated components are critical. More information on the egg packer system will be presented in a subsequent module.